Hello friends, welcome to my channel, and today we're gonna talk about SSL inspection in Palo Alto Firewall. So what exactly the use of SSL inspection? So let's assume this user wants to go to internet and he wants to go on some HTTPS site. Let's assume it's a Facebook. Okay, so once we do the blocking, a URL blocking on Palo Alto Firewall, what happens? It blocks the HTTP traffic, but in case of HTTPS, it's a encrypted traffic, he will not be able to understand and the URL will not be blocked. So for that, what we can do is we will use SSL decryption. Okay, we'll decrypt the packet and we'll see what exactly inside it. If it is allowed for that user, it allows the connection, otherwise it blocks the connection. Okay, we are going to understand the concept behind SSL inspection with all the explanation and SSL handshake as well. So I'll request you to watch this video till then, and please subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon so that whenever I upload any video, you'll get notification. And without any further delay, let's get started. So friends, before moving to SSL inspection, we need to understand what is SSL. Okay, so I have already posted one video on SSL handshake and how SSL works. I'll put on the I button so that you can watch that and you can understand. It is very recommended to know the SSL handshake. Okay, first. So I'll just give a overview of that SSL. So we have a CA server, that is certificate authority, who issues certificate to our sub CA. So let's say we have we can say that CA server is let's assume it's a VeriSign. Okay, he issued the certificate to our organization name as Bikash Tech. Okay, in turn I can issue certificate to the devices. Okay, devices, as this device trusts this sub CA, this device also trusts this sub CA, they can authenticate each other and they can transfer their data. Like that it is. Overview. Okay, now in this case what happens is this device is acting as sub CA server. Okay, now when this user initiate connection to internet, let's say if he goes to google.com, okay, as this is a HTTPS connection and he is having the CA certificate, he will present the certificate to user, says that I am the Google server. Okay, now once he saw that, as he is a CA, he will trust and he will say okay, give me the page. In turn, Palo Alto Firewall, what it does is he will initiate a new connection with google.com. And he will get the page. Why he is doing this? Because let's say if I block Facebook for a user, okay, if user tries to initiate a facebook.com, he requested for facebook.com and that is blocked in the firewall, he will drop the packet and he will never initiate traffic to internet. That is the reason He do these things. Okay. Otherwise, if it is not there, then any user can go on internet which site is blocked. Because nowadays all the sites are HTTP sites only. Maximum sites I can say. All the Twitter, LinkedIn, Facebook, if you see any social networking, everything is HTTPS. Okay. So that is the reason we are doing SSL inspection. So how you can make Palo Alto as a CA server that we are going to see, and how the traffic will be allowed to, or how Palo Alto will check that traffic that we are going to see now. Now we are going to learn how to configure Palo Alto firewall as CA server and do the SSL inspection. So first we are going to log into Palo Alto firewall. So what we need to do is we need to go to device and then CA certificates. Don't go to default trusted certificate. Go to device certificate, click generate, type local certificate name. We can give any name that is a common name, and we want this firewall act as CA server. Okay, otherwise you can also import it. Like let's say if you get a certificate from the VeriSign or some other root CA, that you can import it over here, that I was talking about the sub CA. So click on CA server, click generate, so it will get generate successfully now, and click on certificate and put a tick on forward trust certificate on forward. What exactly the forward is, that I have explained the concept. Like whenever the user tries to initiate traffic to internet, it goes to Palo Alto firewall. Palo Alto firewall will take that traffic and he will present his certificate to the user, and then in turn on behalf of user he will go on internet like that. So trust means Palo Alto trusting the certificate, or Palo Alto is not trusting that URL. So we are just doing for this lab. Click OK. Click on the certificate, export. OK. So you need to save it. Open the folder. And what we need to do is we need to install that certificate. Okay, as this is not a trusted CA, because in the browser we have some known CA servers and certificates in the browser, as this is not, so it says this is not a trusted. Click on install. Next. So where we need to place it? To trusted root certificate authorities. Click OK. Go next. Finish. Yes, I want to install this. So the certificate is now installed. Okay. Now the next thing is, what we need to do is go to policy. Create a policy. Name it do not encrypt. Okay, as per the encryption law, we will not in decrypt sorry, it should be decrypt. We are some certain category we should not encrypt, so for this reason we are just creating it. So from inside to outside, Okay. So financial services at some health and shopping. These three categories we are not going to decrypt. Okay, option none, no decrypt. Okay, we'll put one rule more that we are going to decrypt. Okay, click no. Source add from inside, destination outside, service and option. In option, what we need to do is decrypt SSL forward proxy that I have. The certificate but that we have generated, it is for SSL forward proxy. So it will take that certificate and decrypt it. Click on commit, validate the commit whether it is conflicting with other configuration. Okay, it's not. Go ahead and put it commit. As this is a user machine, so we are accessing from here and we have downloaded the certificate in the browser, and this is inside user. We are not using this management right now. Okay, click close. And go to the browser and so now we are going to access some website now. So we'll try to access google.com. Now it's getting open now. Okay. Now if we try to open some other website like shopping dot com, Amazon dot com, at a shopping site, it is also getting open. So this is how the SSL inspection work in Palo Alto Firewall, and this is what I wanted to show you guys. If you have any queries, please feel free to comment on the comment section, and I think this video will be very very much helpful for you. Thank you so much for watching.